Hare Rama, Hare राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम Thank you. राम हरे राम 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण हरे राम राम हरे 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 कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 नाम संकीर्तन की
ज्ञानंजन शलाक्य चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः वाञ्छाकल्पत्रुभ्यश्च कृपा सिन्धुभ्यो च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः नमो महावदानाय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदाय कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्यनाम्नि गौरविषये नमः तप्त कांचन गौरांगे राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानु सुते देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिय हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधु दीनबंधो जगतपते गोपेश गोपिका कांत राधा कांत नमोस्तुते वृंदाय तुलसी देवाय
कृष्ण भक्ति
देवी सत्यवते नमो नमः जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद
हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्णा हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
कंटिन्यूशन द ग्लोरिफिकेशन ऑफ द होली नेम दे आर बीइंग sing the pastimes of the Kabir Guru, sing the glorification for him since last Saturday. And today is Saturday, it's 8 days. But there is so much to be spoken. Another, if we have 10 days, still it may or it may not be. That is within my capacity, I'm saying. It is unlimited. There are so much to be spoken. There are so many points which are not even taken up. Anyway, whatever the Lord wishes, only to that extent a human being can speak. And I have spoken within my capacity. We are seeing the pastor Haridas Thakur, who is a Nam Acharya. So we definitely need the mercy of Haridas Thakur to do our bhajan, to do Harinam. And we also heard yesterday how he was tortured and all. He was flogged, beaten. He was declared dead, and by the grace of Mother Ganga, he came back to life again. All this we had heard yesterday, and today we are continuing. He was staying in the cave and being Harinam. There was a snake there, a poisonous snake, who had a jewel in the head. And the snake was so poisonous that he managed to breathe. The fumes which were coming out used to pollute the whole atmosphere, and people used to get itching sensation. They didn't know what to do. They could not understand. Then they went to a doctor. The doctor said there must be a poisonous snake around. Then they went to Haridas Thakur while not feeling anything as such. No itching sensation. He was in a constant state. Maybe that was not going to feel. So when they went to Haridas Thakur and said, I believe there is a poisonous snake here in one of the caves, and because that we are feeling very much itching sensation and it will be very difficult for us to come over here. What do we do? Haridas Thakur was very compassionate. He says, if the snake doesn't go out from here, I will leave this particular place. After some time, they see a snake with a jewel in the head, shining brightly, a very big snake, leaving the cave and going away. And after that, they never had problem. Meaning, to a devotee, even a snake heart gets changed. If you are a true devotee, he cannot bear to see a devotee suffering. He says, it's better I go away because of being a devotee is suffering. That is the power of the holy name. To that extent, the heart of the opposite man can be transferred. Because the holy name being not different from the Lord, when the holy name manifests, the Lord automatically manifests in the heart. He was staying with Advaita, Haridas Thakur was staying with Advaita Acharya. And since he was staying, he, for him, Advaita Acharya was everything. They used to go to a house of a Jamindar whose name was Hirne and Govardhan Majumdar. They were two brothers. They had a son named Raghunath Das. Of course, Raghunath, he had a son. After he becomes Raghunath Das Goswami, he becomes. And they were very respectful toward Advaita Acharya and Haridas. And Raghunath Das had the association of Advaita Acharya and Haridas Thakur from his very childhood. And Haridas used to always chant the holy name. Seeing this, even Raghunath Das was influenced by it. And he also used to chant the holy name. One day in the assembly of this Majumdar, Haridas Thakur was sitting and chanting the holy name. A discussion arose. One of the Brahmanas who was there, he asked a question to Haridas Thakur. I will read the question here and translate in English. Bhagwanam Japka Antim Falkya. What is the fruit of chanting the holy name? What is the ultimate fruit? Usse kis prakar ki sukh ki prapti hoti? What kind of happiness you get by chanting the holy name? Kya harismaran karne se sabhi dukho ka atyant abhav ho sakta hai? Can all problems be solved just by chanting the holy name? क्या केवल नाम जप से मोक्ष मिल सकता है? By only chanting holy name can we get liberation? This or the questions which arose in the assembly and the Brahmin is asking Haridas. I asked in a very humble way, said, what can I speak to all learned people over here? Since you asked me the question, and it's always pleasing to glorify the holy name, for my own purification, I'll be telling. This is what Haridas said in a humble way. भगवान नाम जप का सर्वश्रेष्ठ फल ही है कि इसके जप से हृदय में एक प्रकार की अद्भुत प्रसन्नता प्रकट होती है. The highest benefit to get by chanting the holy name is to get a happiness which you cannot get in this world anywhere. A different type of happiness to get, because the name is not different from the Lord. So when you are chanting, of course we are in the condition state, that's why we find the name and the Lord different. But those who are in an elevated state, who are advanced Vaishnavas, when they chant the holy name, the Lord automatically manifests and all His person manifests in front of the eyes. We do not experience it, but the elevated state experience it. So he said, the happiness which you get by chanting in holy name is indescribable, because the Lord, I am seeing the Lord and His person, so that happiness I cannot describe. उस प्रसन्नता जने सुख का आस्वादन करते रहने ही भगवत नाम का सर्वश्रेष्ठ और सर्वोत्तम फल है. टू एक्सपीरियंस दैट हैप्पीनेस इज द हाईएस्ट बेनिफिट ऑफ चैंटिंग द होली नेम. व्हाट हैज बीन वी हैव सीन द पास्ट एंड व्हाट एल्स यू वांट. द लॉर्ड इज डांसिंग इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू, यू आर ही डूइंग डिफरेंट पास्ट टाइम्स, सो दैट इज द हाईएस्ट बेनिफिट व्हाट यू आर एक्सपीरियंसिंग. दैट ब्लिस व्हिच यू आर गेटिंग, दैट इज द हाईएस्ट. देयर इज नथिंग ग्रेटर देन दिस ब्लिस देन एक्सपीरियंसिंग द पास्ट टाइम्स ऑफ द लॉर्ड. भगवत नाम जप करने वाले को करने वाला मोक्ष दुखों के अत्यंत अभाव की इच्छा ही नहीं करता. Those who are chanting the holy name, they do not desire to cut off their sufferings, neither they desire liberation. Because I told you many times, the suffering is a condition of a mind. Because we are attached to material things, and things go that don't go our way, then we become unhappy. But if you are attached to the Lord, so how are you suffering? Whatever happens, it doesn't make a difference to you. So nobody makes us unhappy. It is our bad habits that are making us unhappy. I am attached to this. I want him to behave that way. He doesn't behave. I'm attached to this mobile. I'm attached to this glass. I'm attached to this bottle. And if it breaks, I become very upset. If I'm not attached, then how will it affect me? It will still break. Everything has to be destroyed with time. Because I'm attacked, I'm being very upset. If my attachment to Krishna increases, the worldly attachment decreases. So I'm never upset. I'm always blissful. So we have to become blissful by through practice, by chanting, experiencing the pastime of being attached to Krishna. Then you can never be unhappy in this life. And liberation is very insignificant thing for a devotee. He said, "What will I do? The liberation? Suppose you ask liberation, the Lord gives you His abode. Then what happens?" The Lord incarnates. He does some particular leela. He's playing with his friends. Oh Lord, I also want to be a participant. He said, then you should have asked for bhakti. Why do you ask for liberation? A devotee who asks for bhakti, he comes with the Lord, takes some role in his pastimes, and with the Lord, he goes back to his abode. He is never born in this material world. That's why the devotee never asks for liberation, because I will be deprived of that pastime, of that love, of that enjoyment which I can experience with Lord. So that for a devotee, liberation is the most insignificant thing, is the most worst thing, and very few people understand this. So what a devotee will always ask and take is the devotional service, and with devotional service he will always be participating in some pastime of the Lord. Some or other will be given to him, and he will be enjoying with it and be happy in serving the Lord. पर सगुण निर्गुण दोनों के चक्कर से दूर रहता है. सम से द लॉर्ड हैज फॉर्म, सम से द लॉर्ड हैज नो फॉर्म. ही इज अवे फ्रॉम ऑल दिस. दिस इज जस्ट अ ज्ञानी से की बट आर बीइंग अमंग देमसेल्फ बिकॉज़ द डिवोटी इज एक्सपीरियंसिंग द पावर ऑफ गॉड, सो ही स्टेज अवे फ्रॉम इट. उसका तो अंतिम फिर भगवान नाम जप ही होता है. ही ओनली focus is God, just to chant the holy name. Why? If you are chanting, the Lord is manifesting. So what else you want? What is higher than this? कहीं भी रहे, कैसे भी परिस्थिति में रहे, कोई भी योनि में wherever is, whatever condition he says, whichever form he gets, but in any species he goes, निरंतर भगवान नाम का स्मरण करना, always the remembrance of the Lord should be maintained, his name should be chanted. This is called a devotee also. Shankar, Kobi, Bhagavan naam se prathak raha. For a moment also, he doesn't want to stop chanting the holy name. See, this thing you will automatically experience that as you go on chanting, as you try to increase your chanting, after a certain period, once you cross 80 round, 90 round, 100, you will feel your tongue will not want to stop. You will feel guilty, oh why am I stopping? You have to experience certain things. I can only inspire you, but the taste you have to experience by doing it. I cannot give you the taste. If sugar is sweet, how it is sweet, you have to experience it. I cannot give the taste of sugar. Similarly, the holy name, I can inspire you, but you have to chant to experience the taste. Ye naam jam ka antim lakshya, that is the ultimate truth, that I do more chanting. Why? Because I do chanting, the Lord passes them, the Lord will manifest, there is nothing higher than what I swear on. He doesn't want to give up chanting for more. The moment I give up by chanting, the Lord's passes will disappear from my eyes. So how can I stop chanting? That is why I was speaking today in the house, the Goswamis, they offered obeisances to Satyadevi. They offered obeisances to the Gayatri Mantras. They offered obeisances to all the Devtas. They said, please excuse us, we have no time to do Gayatri, we have no time to do Sandhya Vandan, we have no time to offer obeisances because we cannot stop chanting the holy name. Because if I do Gayatri, if I do Sandhya Vandana and other things, then I will have to stay away from the Lord for that particular moment, say 1 hour or half an hour. I cannot get to see the separation when I am chanting the holy name Hare Krishna Mahamantra, the Lord's passions are visible or manifest in front of my eyes. How can I leave and do that? See, that is the mood that happens. All these are insignificant when compared to the Hare Krishna Mahamantra. This is what the Goswamis pray and they give up everything. At a certain stage, when your chanting comes to 3 lakhs and you go to that one and you go down, then at that stage nothing is required, because when you do continuously, when the pastime, the Lord will be visible to you in your heart, you will see, you will say, I will not do anything, any other act except chanting holy. I cannot have no time for even something. But that stage comes to chanting regularly, do it and experience it. भगवान नाम के साधक का साधक और साधन भगवान नाम ही है, द गोल एंड द साधक. द गोल एंड द वे टू अटेन इज ओनली हरिनाम, दैट इज ओनली थिंग. द गोल इज ऑल्सो हरिनाम, बिकॉज आई एम नॉट इक्वल फ्रॉम कृष्णा, एंड द साधन ऑल्सो इज हरिनाम, दैट विल क्लींस योर हार्ट एंड मैनिफेस्ट द पावर इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू. भगवान नाम से वो किसी प्रकार के फल की इच्छा नहीं रखता. By chanting holy, he doesn't want any other fruit except serving the Lord. He said, I only know this one, I do not know anything beyond it. This is why Haridas Thakur told the Brahman. Everyone felt happy that Brahman, he was Gopal Chandra Chakravarti. He was also a servant, a worker in the Mazumdar family. He did accept. He used studies, used intelligence. And he said, no, this is just what you are saying. He said, people who don't want to read and write, or don't study, only they speak such nonsense. This is what that Gopal Chandra Chakravarti said. He said, knowledge means you should study the Shastras. But what the Gita says? Krishna said, by all the Vedas I am to be known. If you know Krishna, you know all the Vedas. What a simple thing. If you know Krishna, because the fruit of saying all is that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And once they settled the head, they settled all the 4 Vedas. It is such a simple thing. But people with lot of sinful activities or karmas, they are not able to understand it. And then they try to use logic. He says, can the holy destroy all the unhappiness? He said, where in the Shastra these words are mentioned? They are just for people to have some faith in it. That Harinam doesn't destroy the miseries of a person. Haridas spoke very authoritatively. People who talk this way, they are only just speaking nonsense. They do not understand the meaning of the importance of the Harinam. Harinam is not an ordinary thing where you can just speak compare it to something else. That Gopal Chakravarti says, only fools will be swayed by your or by what you speak. I am not a fool, I will not come in your talks. अजामिल जैसा पापी पुत्र का नारायण लेते हुए कर दिया, क्या घर का व्यापी भगवान इतना नहीं समझ सके कि इसने अपने पुत्र को बुलाया? ये अर्थ है तो क्या इसे किसी का उसका स्पीकिंग व्हेन अजामिल कॉल्ड टू हिज सन नारायण जिंदा बात को ही वाज कॉलिंग आउट टू हिज सन देन इसे दिस इज जस्ट एन एक्सप्लेनेशन एज अ राइटिंग टू पीपल आर राइटिंग दैट इट्स नॉट एक्चुअल मीनिंग दिस इज नॉट ट्रू हरिदास जी का इसे अर्थ कहने वाले सब अनर्थवादी है इसे मैं कुछ पीपल हु स्पीक नॉनसेंस एंड दिस इज जस्ट मेंशन फॉर द नेम से दे आर ऑक्सी टॉकिंग टोटल नॉनसेंस ही बिकेम एंग्री द चक्रवर्ती गोपाल चंद्र एंड ही से यदि भगवान नाम स्मरण करने से मनुष्य के नीचे जाते रहे तो मैं अपनी नाक कान कटा लो इफ बाई बाई चैंटिंग द होली नेम ऑफ द लॉर्ड अ पर्सन सिंपल एंड लोली बिहेवियर changes, then I am ready to cut off my nose and my ears. Haridas then with Josh Bhaka. Haridas also spoke enthusiastically, if by chanting the holy name of the Lord, a person's sinful activities and his lowliness doesn't go away, even I am ready to cut off my nose and ears. Then we understand, after speaking this, everybody went very silent. Jamindar, that Bajumdar became very unhappy, seeing that he is opposing a Vaishnava, he not having faith in the holy name. The first thing was that he was dismissed from his office. He got dismissed. He lost his job. And within a period of time, people saw his nose and ears were really cut off. With some sickness he had, and his nose, like leprosy or something you can say, his nose and ears melted away, they went away. So it proves that what Haridas was saying was right, and you were speaking against the holy name. The fruit of offending a Vaishnava and the holy name, because holy name is not different from Krishna, is very, very dangerous. If you don't want to do, don't do. But do not speak nonsense against, especially the Vaishnavas, who are glorifying the holy name, who are preaching the holy name. Do not do, because the Lord can tolerate insult towards himself, but he cannot tolerate insult towards his devotees. And the Lord will never forgive you if you offend a Vaishnava. And we do not know who a Vaishnava is. In the house I was speaking, Andhra Maharaj. What has happened? He was thrown away from his house. He was his stepmother told him, you cannot sit on the father's lap and you go away. And he, that poor fellow, went away. He went to his mother. What did his mother say? Do not be envious of your brother. Then what do I do? Because when we are envious, we tend to criticize them. By criticizing our past, it will further go down. Then what do I do? You should love Narayan. When you love Narayan, you will get those things which even your grandfather Shambhu Manu could not get. Rather than criticizing and looking down out of envy, you should love the Lord. When you love the Lord, you get those things which nobody has ever got. This is what we are supposed to do. And what happened? In the end, the Lord manifested, he appeared to before Dhruva now. His brother went into the forest, he was killed, and then mother turned, stepmother went searching, she turned almost mad crazy, and in the forest she was burned. Why? Because of committing offense to Guru. But when she committed offense, he was not a devotee. For the Lord said, he didn't take in that sense. He said, you have committed offense against my devotee, so I will not spare you. So if I insult you today you will not be a Vaishnava. Tomorrow, if you become Vaishnava, then what happens? The Lord will not spare me. So we have no right to insult or humiliate or look down on any person just because today we do not see the other Vaishnava. All of a sudden, if a turn takes place in his life and he becomes a Vaishnava, then the Krishna will say, oh, you are completely Vaishnava, I am not going to spill, and he can be in a horrible situation. So no right to insult anyone, because we do not know what state person is. Speaking of big devotees, we are chanting, do we know in what state other person is? There is a chapter.
सर वो जो थे बैठते थे आराम से रहते थे और उनको गदाधर ने उनको अपना
पुंडरीक विद्यानिधि
he was living like a royal king पुंडरीक विद्यानिधि nobody could understand his devotee and in Ganga was flowing close to him nobody ever seen him go to the Ganga. At night, when everyone was asleep, he used to go and offer obeisances to Ganga. People used to think he doesn't have faith in the Ganga. But when you ask him, why don't you go to Ganga? He says, people are throwing dust and dead bones and they are urinating and doing all nonsense in the Ganga. And Ganga is my mother. I am very pained to see that. Secondly, she is my mother. How can I touch my mother with my leg? That was his conscience. At night when nobody is there, I go and offer obeisance. Just because you do not see, that doesn't mean he is not a devotee. You do not know his consciousness, what state he was in, Kundalini Vidyanidhi. And just because he is surrounded by in the royal way, that Kundalini Vidyanidhi with all servants and beautiful clothes and all. Mansuri, he went with Mukundak and Gadadhar, they both went. Gadadhar, he shall take you to a Vaishnava. He took him to the palace of Pandit Vidyanidhi. He said, oh, is he Vaishnava? The Vaishnava live this way. Then Mukund chanted the shloka of Bhagavat of Purnas, Krishna, Purtamas, and liberation. After one shloka he chanted, he became mad, he tore his clothes, he went rolling down, he lost consciousness, just during the pastime of Lord Krishna. Then Gadadhar said, oh, what an offense have I committed? Why did I think he is not a Vaishnava? He is such an elevated Vaishnava. Then he came and he told Mahaprabhu, how do I rectify this offense? Okay, I will take initiation from Pandit Vidyanidhi and when by the disciple, my offense will be over. Mahaprabhu said, good, that is a good thought. And then he took initiation from Pandit Vidyanidhi. And so we cannot judge who is a Vaishnava, who is not a Vaishnava, just because he is not in front of us, that doesn't mean he is not a Vaishnava. You do not know what is behind you, what is consciousness, what is his state. So do not be judgmental, do not judge people. These are 250 grams of gray matter. It is very, very less to judge. So leave it on the mercy of Lord and do your own bhajan. You see how my bhajan should increase. How should I develop the mood of separation and love for Krishna? That should be our problem. When this big problem arises, I am not getting the mood of separation, I am not getting the love problem, my bhajan not increasing, and all problems in this world will be insignificant. This should be our problem. This is the biggest problem. But we do not have this problem, we have all other problems in life except this problem. There is another incident. In a Hari Mani place, there is another village, this incident took place. Those Brahmins who were staying in the village of Hari Mani, they were very proud of their caste and the knowledge of the Vedas. And Haridas was always sitting, walking, and all the time chanting the Hare Krishna Mahamantra. And they say, you are a Muslim, you are not authorized to chant the Hare Krishna Mahamantra. How are you chanting? And the Shastra mentioned, if a person who is not authorized, and if he does this chanting and all, the whole, there will be famine and people will die and there will be poverty and was not authorized. Haridas spoke in a very humble way. He said, what do I know? But I have heard from the Shastra that by chanting the holy name, different castes, the people, Kira, Poon, Andhra, Pulim, Pulkas, Abhid, Kankhya, Vandali, all people of the most worst class. Anybody who chants the holy name, all their sins are destroyed and they become very purified and they can purify the whole world. And the, everyone has the Adhikar. Adhikar means the right to chant the holy name. You cannot claim that only the Brahmins have. Everyone has a right to chant the holy name. Then the Brahmins started speaking. Okay, if everyone has a right to chant the Hari Name, but mantra jap, everyone doesn't have the right. And you are chanting so loudly, that is the worst form of chanting. You should be chanting in your mind, not even moving the lips. He says, Haridas says, Vedic mantras are to be chanted in the mind. I can understand. The holy name, the louder it is spoken, the more beneficial it is. Not only to the chanter, the one who hears, even to the animals or flies, cockroaches and birds and living trees, they all get liberated. It is the most beneficial thing when you chant not in the holy name. Vedic mantras, I can say, because see, why there are not to be chanting Vedic mantras? Because you have to speak in a particular tone. And if you cannot speak in a particular tone, the effect will be reversed. The Sanskrit words have to, in a particular tone, they have to be recited. And Kali people are not qualified to speak in that very particular tone. They do not have that knowledge. And so that the meaning of the mantras can change if you don't pronounce it properly. But in Harinam, there is no such problem. It can be said anytime, anywhere. And those Vedic mantras have to be chanted while sitting, facing the east, in an asana, and then and you can chant them everywhere. But the holy name being so powerful, it can be chanted everywhere. I had spoken on the second day by this. See, all the mantras have come from Om. And from Om has come from Ram Nam. Because from Om you remove the word Ma, it is Om means when you are unhappy, you say, oh, I'm so miserable. And Om in Sanskrit is also known as Pranav. From the Pranav you remove the word Ra, it is Pranav. So if Ram Nam is there, then Om is there and all the mantras are there. So all the mantras have emanated from Om and Om has emanated from Ram. So by chanting the word Ram, you have chanted all the Vedic mantras. There is nothing left to be chanted. So this is so powerful, the holy name. It is more powerful than the Vedic mantras also. Because the Vedic mantras all have come from the word Ram. They come from Om and Om has come from Ram. And all the knowledge of the Shastras are automatically revealed when one chants the holy name of Ram. This is, I explained in detail, I did 2 days ago. Then he says, these are, the Brahmin say, these are all just mentioned in the Shastras just to attract people, but actually this is not the meaning. People must have faith in their name or some kirtan. That's why somewhere in the Shastra you find these words written, or you should chant the holy name. The real thing is that what a Brahmin is saying, you should have godly qualities in you and then you should do japa. So tell me, how can a person have godly qualities? Is it possible for him to get? And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, Cheto Darpan Majan Bhav Mahatavandira, how these 7 qualities come only through Krishna Sankirtan? It all looks so nice. You should have good qualities and then, but good qualities come only by chanting. When the Lord comes, the good qualities come automatically. They come from the Lord to you. If you put good godly qualities in your heart, then you need not have chanting. God was not required. Because you cannot, that is why God is required, that is why the holy name is required. If we could solve all of our problems, then the Lord was not required. But we cannot solve, we are in helpless state and we have to take the help of a person who is in elevated state or who is all powerful, that is Lord, and then only our problems can be solved. You know, it's very nice and easy to speak, oh, you should do this, do this, do that. But practically, if you see, how is it possible? It means nobody has will ever do chanting of the holy name. Because nobody has godly qualities. I have seen in my life, the last 30 years, which I have been preaching, all people who have come to me were drunkard, they have non-vegetarians and all sorts of activities. I didn't tell any one of them to give up this thing and come to me. I told, please come and sit and hear Harikatha. They should hear Harikatha. Then slowly, I induced them to chant. They started chanting. After chanting 16 rounds, they should tell me, oh, uncle, I feel like giving up now. I said, okay, give up. Then after chanting 32 rounds, they should tell me, oh, I feel like giving up onion, garlic and peacock. I said, give up. Some are able to take initiation, some are not able to take. Their home people were not allowing them to take. So they told me what to do. I said, increase the rounds. What can I do? By mercy of them. And they started chanting 64. For 2-3 months, they chanted 64 rounds. The home people automatically said, please don't take initiation. They cannot stop. Their hearts change. This is what I have practically experienced. So how can you say, give up this, give up that, and then come? You let that person come, whatever state is, let him come. Let him first hear Harikatha, let him start chanting, let him take novice even after hearing Harikatha and chanting. Let him take slowly, when his willpower will increase. Once he starts getting a taste of the holy name, automatically he will give up all the demonic qualities. By telling a person you are this way, looking down, criticizing him, and that fellow will stop coming. At least be happy he is coming to Harikatha. At least by hearing you can be close to him and you can induce him to chant the holy name. And the holy name will take care of everything. But people with poor fund of knowledge, they don't understand this. And they are proud of their caste and their qualities, and then they look down on others, and that's why people are afraid to come and they don't even come. Oh, how can we come? They are not qualified, we cannot do that. Then they run here and there, then they fall down totally. So we don't even give them a chance to improve. Then he says, very important line, यदि नाम जप से ही मनुष्य का उद्धार हो जाता फिर इतने शास्त्रों की रचना क्यों होगी? If by chanting the holy name a person can be liberated, then why have so many shastras come? What they need of Vaishnava? Everybody can chant and get out. What the Haridas says, the very important line. Haridas ने उसी नंबर से कहा, पंडित की श्रद्धा होने तो कठिन है, यदि सबको में केवल भोग नाम पर ही पूर्ण श्रद्धा जम जाए तो शास्त्र की आवश्यकता नहीं रहती। कहते तो हैविंग फेथ इन द होली इज द मोस्ट डिफिकल्ट थिंग। इफ यू कैन हैव फेथ इन द होली नेम देन द शास्त्र आर नॉट रिक्वायर्ड एट ऑल। बिकॉज बाय चैंटिंग द लॉर्ड्स नेम द लॉर्ड पास्टर द लॉर्ड इज रिवील्ड टू यू व्हाट इज द शास्त्र। द शास्त्र हैव लिमिटेड थिंग्स। एवरीथिंग इज रिवील्ड टू द होली नेम। जस्ट टू हैव फेथ इन द होली नेम दिस शास्त्र इज रिक्वायर्ड। One who has acquired absolute faith in the holy name and he is chanting like either one and two rounds, then the past times are revealed to you. You do not require any shastras. He says, what I am seeing in front of my eyes is much more than what I am even reading. I have not even read those things which the past of the Lord is manifesting in front of my eyes. He says, what is written in the shastra? Have faith in the Lord. Bhagavan may shraddha karo. Did he have faith in the Lord? To have faith in the Lord, this is what the Shastras are meant for. To induce you to have faith in the Lord and chant the name. There is no other reason for the Shastras. Understand? Shraddha Vishwas ki pushti ke lihi tumhi the Shastra hai. To induce faith in the Lord and the holy name, the Shastras are manufactured. If you can have this, you don't require anything. Because we don't have, we become weak at times, our mood fluctuates, then to read the Shastra, that our mood will get transformed and then do. But if you can maintain, if you see, these things are at a lower level. But once we reach a high state of chanting and we can maintain that mood and chant about say 120 to 192 round daily, then I think then in that transcendental state, our mood will not even fluctuate at all, and then we do not require any Shastra at this stage. Then the Brahman said, in anger, यदि केवल भगवत नाम जप से सब कुछ हो जाए तो मैं अपने नाक कान दोनों कटवा लूंगा. इफ एवरीथिंग हैपेंस टू द होल देन आई एम रेडी टू कट माय नोज एंड इयर्स. आई जस्ट कैन दिस अप टू यू. इफ यू डोंट हैव फेथ व्हाट कैन आई डू. That Brahman had a sickness, penis root. I don't know what is penis root, whatever is the name of a sickness. And people saw slowly, slowly it started melting, and he lost his mouth and ears. This is how what happens when you offend a holy name and you offend, because holy name is so merciful, is more merciful than the Lord. I will explain to you how. Lord appeared. And Treta Yuga and killed the Rakshasas. He appeared. But whoever has chanted a holy name, the propensity to sin have all been destroyed by chanting. The Lord gave happiness to few people like saints and all. Not to everybody, because who came to his lotus feet, he awarded them happiness. But whoever has taken the shelter of holy name, either today or in the future, all are awarded happiness. All will be awarded happiness, have been awarded, we have taken shelter of the holy name. The Lord gave this Vibhishan and Sugriva the kingdoms back. But whoever is chanting the holy name, taken shelter of holy name, they have their financial condition has all improved. At least in my life, I have seen, I don't know about here, in India, in Malaysia, in India, for the last 30 years, I have been saying, whoever is chanting the holy name, his financial, material and spiritual, both the things have improved. What he was 10 years or 20 years ago, is it to say, he is no longer in the state. He is far, far better than what he used to be. And he could not even imagine his condition materially would change, and it has changed. So the holy name gives that much of benefit. It is more merciful than the Lord himself. Now, the Lord wanted to build a bridge to go to Lanka. He had to do a lot of efforts, he had to build or get mountains from there and then build a bridge. But by chanting the holy name, the biggest portion of earth and that can easily be crossed over. To build a bridge to go, it took time, some days or maybe some months to build, to cross a small ocean. Which is the biggest ocean? The cycle of birth and death, and that can be destroyed immediately by chanting the holy name. So isn't the name more merciful than the Lord? I'll give one more example. The Lord was, when they were putting the stones on the sea, the stones were drowning. So what did they do? They started adding Ramnam on the stone. And the stones started floating. So they, whichever stone they were writing, the name Ram, those stones were floating, and which they didn't write, they were drowning. So they said, okay, we'll write Ram. So Lord Ram saw, they are writing my name, and they are, the stones are floating, so I should also help them. So Lord took the stone and put in the water. The stone got drowned. Lord was surprised. He again took the second stone and put in the ocean. That also went down, drowned. The third and the fourth. Lord is asking Hanuman, what is the problem? They are writing my name and that stone are floating, and whichever I am putting in the water, they are drowning. Hanuman said, Lord, whomever you give up, he will drown, and whoever takes shelter of the holy name, only he will float. Because you are giving them up, whomever you give, he is bound to drown in the material world, and whoever takes shelter of the holy name, only he will float and he will go up. So this is the importance of the holy name. And one last person, of course that is a very deep and a big, but I am just going to read to you. The Lord is asking a question to Ramanand Rai about the bhav of the gopis, and he says, what should I tell you? Prabhu, Radha's faith is not an ordinary love. Worldly people cannot understand it. They are not authorized to understand. They cannot understand it. It's better I don't speak much on this topic because the already unauthorized this is what Raj Raman says. And Bhakti Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada says, after 15 or 20 years of chanting 64 rounds of the holy name, one is qualified to listen the pastor, intimate pastor of Radha and Krishna. Then he will take in the right sense and he will elevate it because that is the highest thing. If today a person gives the intimate pastor Govindila Amrit, another verse of the intimate pastor Radha Krishna, the lusty worldly desire will rise in his heart and he will follow. So everyone should lead as per his capacity. If I give a post and a student in 9th standard books, he will not understand, he will fail. He will not be able to understand. Only when he is qualified in the 9th standard will he be able to 9th standard books. Similarly, when we are qualified to enter those deep, after 15 or 20 years of chanting 64 Hari, Malas of Harinam, we are qualified to enter those deep mysteries of the Radha Krishna intimate pastimes. So that is the highest thing, no doubt, but first qualify. And then you will get everything, deserve, and then you will get. How do I qualify? 15 years or 20 years, Prabhupada said, 64 on the book, you automatically will be qualified for all those things. Do not jump at this stage, buy a book and try to read and do, and then bring it to your total downfall. This is what people are doing and they are falling down and they don't even understand the mysteries of Krishna and Radha. He said only the great gopis can understand it. Except the gopis, nobody has the authority to enter this pastime of Radha and Krishna because of their intense love for them. We do not have intense, they have undivided love. They can run, they can give up the family in a moment, in whatever state they are, and run for Krishna just by hearing his flute or by his call. They cannot do because they are not attached to Krishna. That's why we cannot run. And if we artificially try to do it, it will be a sin and we will fall down. So first, develop that much love, the mood of separation, when you really cry for Krishna, then maybe you can behave that way. Then there will be no fault. If that stage comes, please do not be artificial and try to go. Live it as it is. Do you keep your being of bhajan, keep on chanting the holy name. Holy name will qualify you to enter into that bhava. Do not rush. Let things happen gradually as it has to happen. You be sincere in chanting the holy name and leading the pastor Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and others pastor, and once you are qualified, you will automatically want to enter and everything will be able to do. गोप्य के इंद्रियों की अभिलाषा नहीं होने तो राधिका के साथ कुंज में गेलिन करते श्री कृष्ण के वक्रमया प्रेम लीला ही अत्यंत प्रिय है. What does the gopi want? They do not want their sense satisfaction. They want to please Krishna every day. We want to satisfy our sense, that is known as lust kaam, and those who want to satisfy Krishna, that is known as love. When you love somebody, you want to give him happiness, you want to see his happiness. You do not want anything for yourself. In love, you sacrifice. The first quality, the symptom of love is sacrifice. To for his sake, to make him happy, I am ready to give everything. There are their insults, humiliation. I don't care for the happiness of my beloved. I am ready for everything, but I have to do that. That is the first symptom of love. Person who wants to set his own senses, he cannot sacrifice. It means he has no place of love and he has only lust because I want to satisfy my senses and nothing. I should eat, I should get that. I should get, I don't care whether you eat or no. I must get my cold drink, I must have my chocolate, I don't care you care. That is lust. We should, there's a difference, it both appear to be same, but there's a big difference. Here we want to satisfy senses and in love we want to satisfy Krishna. That is a big difference between both of these. अपने लिए भी कुछ नहीं चाहते. They do not want anything for themselves. Their all their desires, all their feelings, and all their actions, by words, mind, and action, what they do and the senses, they only want to see their Radha Krishna are happy. What do I do to make them happy? They have only one thing in their head. How to make them happy? What activity should I do? They are always thinking of that only. Just to please them, what will make them most happy? This is actual love. How to please? the Lord, Radha and Krishna. Those who want to experience this type of love, they must be ready to sacrifice everything and there should be no selfish motives. We have to follow the footsteps of the gopis. Without entering the gopi bhav, you are not authorized to enter into those niras because you have some trace of selfish motive in your heart. You do not have pure love. You are not willing to give everything to give alone. You have some, oh, I must get something, at least one person I must get, some enjoyment I must get. No. When you love somebody, by seeing them happy, your happiness increases 1,000 times, although you are suffering. But you are not suffering. Because you see happy, you might get inconveniences. But you are happy to see them happy. This is the gopi bhav. How to make the Lord happy? चाहे जब से तब से वेदाभ्यास से अर्थ यज्ञ ज्ञान द्वारा इस रस सागर में प्रवेश होने का अधिकारी बन जाएगा तो उनके बल सब बड़ी थिंग्स ही बाय जप अभय तप अभय शनिद वेदांत अभय यज्ञ एंड अदर आई बी एबल टू अटेन इम्पॉसिबल फॉर टू अटेन है उस अमृत महासागर के समय पहुंचे तो भक्ति ही एक मात्र ओनली वन भक्ति इज द ओनली क्वालिफिकेशन रिक्वायर्ड टू एंटर इनटू दिस मास्टर to get this qualification. Bhakti is the only way. As Veda Vyasa said, Nand Nandan Bhavan Vasudev jis prakar bhakti ko bhakti ko bhakti ke sahaj praap ho jate hain. As Lord Krishna Nand Nandan is attained only by bhakti, by the devotees, usi prakar de abhimani, those who have got the bodily conception, karma prani, who are involved in karma kand, and the gyanis, they don't attain the Lord. He said the gopis are considered the highest. Nobody can equal the gopis' love. Without taking the dust of the lotus feet, they cannot get the authority. What do you mean the dust of the lotus feet? See, that doesn't mean, okay, you should not, I put dust on the feet and I take that, I'll take on dust. It means what? When you offer obeisances to somebody, you show how humble you are. When you take the dust, it means you are lower than the dust. You consider yourself insignificant. That humility has to be there. That is the qualification to take. Understand? When you say the dust of the lotus feet, it means you are lower, you consider yourself lower than even the dust. That state of humbleness in the heart has to be there and then you are qualified to enter. But people think, oh, dust, oh, I've taken the dust, you're walking, take the dust, and then I'll attain. Oh, that is not the way. We have to understand the actual meaning, being humbler than feeling yourself lower than the dust also. The dust is always below the feet. Oh, I'm even lower than the dust. That feeling of humbleness, low feeling, the feeling that I'm useless, qualifies you to attain. I am willing to serve the Lord, sacrifice everything for Him, give up my whole body, mind, and words. Just to please him, irrespective of people, appreciate me, they criticize me, they taunt me, they humiliate me, I have no problems. I will do everything just to make him happy. That feeling of shamelessness, you can say, has to be there. Because the feeling of shame is a big deterrent in attaining the Lord. What will people think? What will people say? Gopi didn't bother about that. Who are people to judge us? Well, unqualified people, given appreciation letter from people who are degraded, unqualified. Very sad. Our standard is not public opinion. We was for the Bhagavad Gita and the Ramayana, not that for public opinion. Sorry. People can call us, even you tell a content here and take a job, people will still talk nonsense about you. So what is the big deal? So why not sacrifice for the Lord and attain Him? Try to make Him happy. See, you have to understand this deep truth, what is, how deep it is. The shamelessness is a very important thing. One day, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asked Rai Ramananda Rai, Rai Maharshi, mujhe sampurna vidya mein shesh para vidya bataiye, jisse bharata gosi ko vidya nahi, which is the highest knowledge after attaining nothing remains to be known. Which is the highest knowledge to be attained? After attaining nothing remains to be known. Right felt of the assured Nasa Prabhu, what can I say? Shri Krishna Bhakti ki attain or Sarvapar Vidya Mohi Gonsakya. The Krishna Bhakti is the highest with the knowledge. Then nothing equal to it. The rest everything is total zero. The highest knowledge is to attain Krishna Bhakti. We should endeavor to attain Krishna Bhakti. Thus everything is useless. The highest knowledge is Krishna Bhakti. Love for Krishna, we should endeavor to attain it. Besides that, everything is useless. This is what question. Then we ask another question. Sarvashrestha kaunsi kahi jati? Which is the best faith a person can attain? Oh, he is the president of Malaysia, or he is a prime minister, he is a president of this organization. People are famous for that. He says, which faith is considered to be the best? Raya ne kaha, the Raya Ramayana Raya saying, Prabhu Shri Krishna ke samman se lagu bhai chuna hai, yehi sarvottam kirti hai. You are known in this world as a devotee of Krishna, this is the best faith. To be known as a servant of Krishna, that is the best faith. There is nothing higher than that. Not with this organization or the country or this or that, to be associated with Krishna. Oh, he is a devotee of Krishna. People look, that is the best thing you can get. He is a servant of Krishna. Then Prabhu asks, Acha, aise sarva sampatti kaunsi hai, kiske samne sabhi sampattiyan to samjhi ja sake. What is the wealth which is considered to be highest and all other wealth are considered insignificant? Raja uttar diya, Raya speaking, Nikun ki vihari, Radha Vallabh ki avrai bhakti, jiske hrudaya mein vidyaman hai, vahi shreshth sampattishali purush hai. In whose heart, Radha Vallabh bhakti is residing, he is the richest person. He is the most wealthiest person. This is the best wealth a person can get. The who is getting the bhakti of Radha Vallabh and is residing in his heart. उसकी समता का पुरुष त्रिभुवन में कोई नहीं हो सकता. Nobody can equal him in all the three worlds. Who has got the wealth? So which wealth we have to attain? The wealth of bhakti of Radha and Krishna. That is the wealth we have to attain. And as we have to go from one state to another, you require some money, say 500 or 1000 ringgits to go. Similarly, to attain, to go to Goloka Vrindavan, we must have the wealth of bhakti. The wealth of the holy name. Because without money you cannot go from one place to another. Similarly, to go to the abode of Lord, we must have the wealth of the holy name, of love, of the bhakti of Lord, and that will qualify us to take us back to God. If you don't have, you are a pauper, you are dying as a pauper. You are the poorest man in the world. Although you may be worldly very rich, but you are the most poor man, because at the time of that, the worldly riches are here, and then you will be going to hellish condition, not to the Goloka, because you do not have the wealth of love of God, of Radha Vallabh. Then the Lord asks another question. Mujhe bataiye ki sabse bada dukh kaun sa hai? Which is the biggest unhappiness in this world? What is the biggest misery of this world? Rudra with crying and unable to speak, Raya Maharsha said, Prabhu, देशम श्री हरि का हृदय में स्मरण न हो रहे उसी समय विषय भोगों की बातें सोचने लगे वही सबसे बड़ा दुख है. द मोमेंट वी फॉरगेट राधा कृष्ण एंड व्हेन वी थिंक ऑफ वर्ल्डली ऑब्जेक्ट्स इट मींस वी आर द मोस्ट मिजरेबल पीपल. व्हाई? व्हेन यू थिंक ऑफ वर्ल्डली ऑब्जेक्ट्स एंड द वर्ल्डली पीपल, ओ माय रिलेटिव बिहेव दैट वे विद मी. He insulted me, my friend behaved that to me. In office I had this bad encounter today, something went wrong. Whenever worldly thoughts come in the head, you are going to feel unhappy and lonely. So I meant now as you're sitting in Katha, you are forgot everything. So you are not at all miserable. You were miserable say half an hour, 1 hour ago, but now you're not miserable. But once you leave this, and if you do not think of the past times, and again worldly thoughts come, then again you will become miserable. So who is making you miserable? Your own thoughts and bad habits are making you miserable. So you have to, through your practice, you have to change your thoughts and your habits by repeatedly reading the pastimes of the Lord, Hare Krishna mantra, and the pastimes of the Lord is different pastimes. You will be engrossed in that pastime and you will never feel miserable. Although those things are still happening, people are abusing you, they are criticizing you, they are talking nonsense about you, nothing is wrong, but you are still happy because you are not thinking, you are just thinking of the pastime of the Lord, and that you are enjoying. So nobody can make you unhappy. Because problem is, what he said, let me hear. Why you want to hear? You know he's talking nonsense, still you go and hear. And then you fight. What did you attain? He is not going to change. You let him speak whatever he has to speak. You are an idiot. Yes, I am an idiot. You are a third class person. Yes, I am a third class person. You are the most demonic person. Yes, everything you accept. What he will say, you are, he will get fed up and go in 5 minutes. Simple. And you come and read the pastime of the Lord. And you engross yourself. You are happy. The problem, how he can speak this to me, how he behave this to me, that is okay. Our ego stands up and then that ego gives us problem. He is not giving problem, it is our ego which is giving us problem. Okay, I am the most useless person this earth. Anything else, okay, what else you want to say? Abuse me. He will, what he will say? He will say 3-4 abuse, then he will keep him shut and go away. He will be frustrated. He is not reacting. He is accepting everything. What should I tell him now? Rather than you feel frustrated, he will feel frustrated, and you are thinking of the past time and chanting, you are in bliss. What a simple way. But to understand this, you need budget to understand that simple thing. If you know he is talking nonsense, my family member is talking nonsense in the other room, why do you go and sit and listen? You sit in this room and read. You can hear in YouTube, or you can hear in a CD, you can put a Devi Kirtan. So will you be unhappy? No, so you are making yourself unhappy, nobody can make you unhappy. And you have to make yourself happy by mercy and the love of God. So what is the biggest unhappiness? When we forget Hari and then we start thinking of the worldly objects, then we become unhappy. This is what I remember Mahaprabhu was speaking. And what the devotee experience unhappiness, in what way? If he is a devotee, you still find him unhappy. He feels unhappy due to separation from the Lord. We feel unhappiness due to worldly things. People behave this way, that way, by worldly object. But devotee feels unhappiness. He is not able to see the Lord. He is unable to. This mood of separation is so intense that he starts crying, "Oh Lord, when will I meet you? When will I see you?" He says. So when the devotee that comes, they don't say, "Oh, Dr. Sir, I want to stay alive, give me one day, one moment, I want to speak to my friend." I'll tell you, "No, whole life nobody will listen to you, who will listen to you now?" He said, "Prabhu, please take me away, I want to come, this body is useless, I cannot serve you any longer, it has become old, without, that take me away fast, I want to get a new body and serve you in that abode." He's anxious to leave the body. This was Madhavendra's state of mind when he left the body. He had this state of mind. He was anxious, "Oh Lord, please take me away." He was crying, "When will I have your darshan in this body? I cannot have. I want to have. I want to serve you. Please take me." And he's very anxious to leave. And then and the Lord comes and takes them. Because they're thinking of God. They want to go. Not like us. We are materially so attacked. We don't want to. "Oh, Dr. Sir, please, I want to stay a few more days. Please keep me alive." This is how our condition state is. So what the devotee experience unhappiness? By separation of Lord. That is the biggest unhappiness the devotees experience. That's why the devotees cannot stop talking of Lord. Because they feel happy when they talk of Lord. About the pastime, about his name, they speak, they chant. You see, the devotees, a true devotee will always speak of pastime or he will be chanting all the time. He cannot stop. You tell him, "Okay, no, enough." The devotee sleeps. He cannot, if anybody comes and speak about the pastime, "Why don't talk something else?" He cannot, because he experiencing the separation, mood of separation, by chanting he feels relieved. We do not understand his state of mind. We talk from our point of view, but we do not understand he feels relieved by talking about him. Yes, that was intense love for him, that he cannot speak of anything except for his beloved, that is Radha Krishna. You have to understand all this. And Prabhu asks, "आप मुक्त जीव में सर्वश्रेष्ठ किसे समझते हैं? Who is considered a liberated person? Whom do you consider?" राधे का प्रभु जिसकी संपूर्ण चेष्टाएं श्री कृष्ण की प्रेम प्राप्ति के ही निमित्त हो, whose actions are always, who is to be considered a liberated person? Whose actions are always engaged इन द सर्विस ऑफ कृष्णा जो सदा श्री कृष्ण के ही मधुर नामों को उच्चारण करता हुआ उन्हीं पाने का प्रयत्न करता रहता है who's always chanting the name of Krishna, trying to attain him, always chanting to attain him. All engaging all his senses in the service of the Lord, always chanting the name of Lord to attain his darshan. Vai sarvasya mukta, he is considered a liberated person. What is bondage? Attachment to the material world is called as a bondage. And attachment to Krishna is liberation. Why are we unhappy? Because of our attachment. We are unhappy. So we say, oh, I want to be liberated. What do you mean liberation? Liberation means if you are not attached, so if this sofa breaks or the table breaks, you will not be unhappy. So that means you are liberated already. You are not in bondage. And when you love the God, you can go and come. The past time you are going with the Lord and coming with the Lord. Nothing in the world is binding you, and so you are never be unhappy. Prabhu ne pucha, आप किस गान को सर्वश्रेष्ठ गान समझते हैं? Which is the best song a person can sing? राय ने कहा, श्री कृष्ण गोविंद हरे मुरारी हे नाथ नारायण वासु, the holy name of the Lord. श्री कृष्ण गोविंद हरे नाम और हरे कृष्ण मंत्र मीन द होली नेम ऑफ द लॉर्ड इज द बेस्ट सॉन्ग अ पर्सन कैन सिंग. देयर इज नो सॉन्ग सुपीरियर टू दिस. ये सब मधुर नामों के गान को ही मैं सर्वश्रेष्ठ समझता. द चैंटिंग द होली नेम ऑफ द लॉर्ड by the singing the holy name of the Lord is the best song which I can conceive of. By singing the name of the Lord, as he sings the Hare Krishna Mahamantra, he said that is the best song a person can ever even think of. Prabhu ne pucha, aap jeevo ke kalyan ke liye sarvashreshth karya kise samajhte hain? What do you think is beneficial for an ordinary human being? Which did you consider the best? What should a person do? For the welfare, which concern did you consider the best? Raya ne kaha, mat purushon ke paad mumi pavan parag mein apne mastak ko alankrit banaye rakhna aur unke mukh nishchal amrit vachanon ka karn nadron se nirantar paan karte rehna, isse main jeevon ke kalyan ka mukhya hetu samajhta hu. He should surrender himself to the lotus feet of the elevated devotees, advanced devotees, and continuously hear Krishna katha from them. This is how they are inauspiciousness will be converted into auspiciousness. This is the only way they can, they say, oh, I am so unfortunate, I have a bad period going. That bad period can be transformed into a good period by taking the shelter of the lotus feet of the advanced devotees and hearing continuously Krishna katha from them. Because only when the devotees speak, then you get the bhav, that feeling, the consciousness can rise. Otherwise, this thing you all know, but that feeling consciousness comes when you hear from the mouth of a devotee. So that is what he says, is the best way. Prabhu ne pucha, prani bhakti ke sarva shreshth mohan mein kya vastu hai? What is that thing which a person should always remember and never forget? The Lord is asking, Rai Ramana Rai, tell me, for ordinary man or anybody, or the jivas, what is the thing which you should always remember? Rai Dekha, what is Rai saying? Shri Krishna Govind Hari Murari Jaitna Pranam Vasar, the holy name of Lord is always to be remembered and never to be forgotten. Again, which song is the best song? The holy name of the Lord is the best song. He said in this, just we had to communicate about Shri Krishna Govind Hari Murari Jaitna Pranam Vasar, it's the best song to be sung. And what is to be always remembered? The name of the Lord is to be always remembered. After remembering it, nothing has to be remembered. If you forget everything, no problem, but do not forget the holy name of Lord. You do not remember the shloka, you do not remember the pranam mantra, you do not remember the Bhagavad Gita, you do not remember anything, never mind, but do not forget the Hare Krishna Mahamantra. If you know this, you know everything. Because everything, the whole Bhagavatam is in the Mahamantra. Lord Krishna himself resides in the Mahamantra, and one by chanting, once it fructifies, it grows into a tree, and you will find the Lord as a person or present in this, and you know everything, the whole. Once you know the Lord, you know the whole universe, everything you know, there is nothing else remains to be known. But this is the highest remembrance, the remembrance of the name of Lord. Then the Prabhu asked him, आप ध्यान में सर्वश्रेष्ठ ध्यान कैसे समझते हैं? whose meditation or who for whom should we always continuously think? Whom do you consider the highest thought? What should we think of always? Which is the highest thought we should have? Prabhu Rai ne kaha Shri Vrindavan Bihari ki baaki jhaati ka hi nirantar dhyan bana rahe, to ye sarvashrestha dhyan hai. Always think of Vrindavan Bihari. Vrindavan Bihari is Krishna, Radha Krishna. Always think of him. That is the highest dhyan. Dhyan is meditation. Always think of Radha and Krishna. The form of Radha and Krishna. That is the highest. It is the Vrindavan Bihari who gave pleasures to Vrindavan Bihari, who gave pleasures to the Vrindavan Vasis. You have to always only think of them. If you have a photo in the house, then always see the photo. If you have the building, you can see the building. Or if you, you can go to the nearest temple or somewhere and see. Or you can give the person and meditate. That photo will be always in the book. And always think of that. That is the highest thought you can have. प्रभु ने पूछा आप जीवों के लिए ऐसा सर्वोत्तम स्थान कौन सा समझते हैं जो सर्वोच्च मुख में भूमि लेकर निवास किया जाए. विच प्लेस इज टू बी कंसिडर्ड द हाईएस्ट एंड ऑल अदर प्लेसेस आर इनसिग्निफिकेंट कंपेयर टू इट. विच प्लेस डू यू कंसिडर द हाईएस्ट प्लेस टू रिजाइड. वेयर अ पर्सन शुड रिजाइड. बस सबको छोड़कर वृंदावन वास करना ही जीव का अंतिम निवास. गिव एवरीथिंग एंड जेट इन वृंदावन. वृंदावन को प्रज्ञा करके एक पैर भी कहीं अन्यथा नहीं जाना चाहिए. नेवर गिव अप द प्लेस ऑफ वृंदावन फॉर अ मोमेंट एंड गो आउटसाइड वृंदावन. व्हाट इज वृंदावन? व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ वृंदावन? इज इट अ पैलेस? इट इज अ रोड व्हिच यू कॉल वृंदावन. देन लक्ष्मण वेंट टू सुमित्रा मदर and told, Mother, I am leaving Ayodhya and going to the forest with Ram. I need the permission. You please grant the permission to go. Mother said, you are going to Ayodhya. Mother, I am going to Ayodhya. I am leaving Ayodhya and going. How are you saying going to Ayodhya? What did Sumitra mother say? She said, Lakshman, do you think these palaces and roads are known as Ayodhya? There are so many places everywhere and the roads are there. You can be many Ayodhya. No. What is Ayodhya? That Lord Ram resides, that is Ayodhya. So Lord is going to stay in the forest, so that is Ayodhya. So where does the Lord reside? Where the, his pastimes, his glories are sung by beloved devotees. Where there are Tulsi, Vrindavan means the forest of Tulsi. You can have 8 to 10 pots of Tulsi. You can have a deity or the photo of Radha and Krishna. You are seeing the glories of the Lord Krishna. Day and night you are engaged in speaking about him, chanting his name and glorifying people with one another. You are always in Vrindavan. You are never out of Vrindavan. Vrindavan? Tulsi leaves. The forest of Tulsi. And Lord Krishna has done all his leelas there. We should never leave that place. It means we should make our house Vrindavan. Grow some tulsi pots, some tulsi leaves, have the photo or the deity of Radha and Krishna, always speak, sing his name, glorify him, speak his glory, discuss all the time, go to some, call your friend to your house and discuss about him and immerse in the love. You are never a moment away from God. It is not physically, you have to go and stay there. Even people who are sitting there, they are in dacoity, they are being the rascal, they are thieves, they are sitting there, so that you said that is actually Vrindavan? No. They are actually Brijvasi. Who is the Brijvasi? Who has love for the Lord, natural love for the Lord, who cries for him, who cannot stay without him, he is a Brijvasi. Not by just being physically there, you become a Brijvasi. You don't become Brijvasi by physically going to stay there. The mood of the gopis, when they develop in your heart, then you are a Brijvasi. If the mood of gopis are not developing in your heart, how can you be a Brijvasi? Just by going buying a land or buying a flat and saying, do you become Brijvasi? No. The mood of the gopis has to be that love, that sacrifice, the mood of separation has to be there, then you become a Brijvasi. You understand the deep meanings of it? What I'm trying to say? And everyone can make his house a Vrindavan. Everyone. So whoever comes to your house, he will see tulsi leaves, he will see you speaking the glories of Krishna, you are chanting his name, he will see a beautiful photo in the house, the atmosphere will be so nice. It will be peaceful. I have experienced this. In certain houses I used to go, people have told me this. Before you came and did Hari Katha, the atmosphere in my house was always used to be disturbed. And nobody wanted to come to my house because there was non-veg, alcohol and all that thing going on. And there was this fight and abuses, so nobody wanted to come. Since you have started doing Katha and we have started chanting, neighbors come, they say, we feel peaceful by sitting for 10 minutes in the hall. We come just to feel relaxed. I don't know what is there in the house. Why feel so happy and peaceful? They come, they sit for 15, 20 minutes and then they go away. Why? Because by chanting the name and seeing the glory, the whole vibration atmosphere has changed. The vibration because the holy name is so auspicious, the seeing the glory of the Lord is so auspicious, the whole vibration, the atmosphere has changed of the house. And today people want to come and sit in the house. They do not know why, what they are feeling, but they feel something nice over there. This is how you can surcharge a house, make it so auspicious. So the people will want to come and sit. And when they sit, they will ask you, why are you so good? Why the atmosphere is so nice over there? What you say then? I chant the Hare Krishna mantra, I read the passing of Krishna, so you also do the same thing, you will also get the same feeling. And then people will listen to you. I said they will not listen to you. Increase your bhajan, increase your sadhana. And invite people, just invite them. When they come, they will feel they are happy and the atmosphere is so nice. They will ask you, and then you tell. Some may accept, some may not accept them. But at least they know because of the holy name and the pastimes of the Lord, this place has become glorious. And when you die in such a place, remember in Krishna, you are dying in Vrindavan itself. You are dying in Vrindavan. The Tulsi leaves are there, the Krishna is there in front of you. You have seen these photographs, you have seen the beauty of the Lord. If you are beauty, they have seen the beauty. And that is what a glory is that? Then you definitely go back to Godhead. Yes, I gave an example from the Ramayana, you understand? But actually, you are going to Ayodhya. So, what Guru used to say, everyone should make their house a mud. Means what? As in a mud, there is aarti, there is kirtan, there is katha, there is prasadam. Same thing, if you pour, carry wood in your house, the house becomes mud. What we have done? We have made the mud our house. We go, sleep, eat food and come back. No katha, kirtan, nothing. What we have done is wrong. Everyone should make his house a mud. This is what our Guru used to say. Don't make the mud our house. Make a house a mud. You understand? These are the deep things we should meditate upon, think and try to follow it. Mandasan. बस राधा मुरलीधर का ध्यान करते रहने के लिए और वृंदावन ना छोड़े. यू शुड ऑलवेज थिंक ऑफ राधा मुरलीधर, राधा एंड मुरलीधर, राधा कृष्ण मुरलीधर, वो एज अ फ्लूट इन हिज माउथ, राधा मुरलीधर एंड नेवर लीव वृंदावन एट ऑल. प्रभु ने पूछा देन द लॉर्ड आस्क्ड, अब श्रवण में सर्वश्रेष्ठ श्रवण क्या समझते हैं? विच इज द हाईएस्ट थिंग अ पर्सन शुड ऑलवेज हियर? विच वर्ड्स ही शुड ऑलवेज हियर? राय से श्री कृष्ण गोविंद हरे मुरारे हे तातन वसुदेव, ये संपूर्ण श्रवणों का सार. दिस इज द क्रीम ऑफ ऑल हियरिंग, द हियरिंग द होली नेम्स ऑफ द लॉर्ड इज द हाईएस्ट थिंग. दिस वी शुड ऑलवेज हियर. व्हाट वी शुड सी? द नेम्स ऑफ द लॉर्ड. व्हाट वी शुड रिमेंबर? द नेम्स ऑफ द लॉर्ड. व्हाट वी शुड हियर? द अगेन द नेम्स ऑफ द लॉर्ड. सी ऑल द थिंग्स इन द सेम द होली नेम इज मेंशन. जिसे इसे यथावत रीति सुन लिया जाए फिर उसके लिए कुछ श्रवण करना शेष नहीं रह जाता. One who has heard the holy name of the Lord, there is nothing left for him to hear. Because whatever worldly words are spoken or heard or people speak, they will cause doubts or they will hurt your heart. Because all doubts or something your heart is hurt. Oh, I see, I spoken this word, I hurt, that's why I'm feeling hurt. All doubts will come, what he has spoken, I'm doubting. So when you all time hearing the holy name, even if he is abusing you, you are hearing the holy, you are not hurt, you will never be unhappy. And there is nothing higher than this to be heard. That is holy name. Prabhu ne pucha, ab upasana mein sab upasana kise samajhte hain? Whose prayer should we do? Which is the highest prayer which should be done and whose is to be done? Raya ne kaha, Yuga Sarkar ke siva aur kuch bhi aur us aur upasana ki hi kiski jaate. Except Yuga means Radha Krishna, the two, except their bhajan, whose bhajan else is left to be done. Only his their bhajan is to be done, Radha and Krishna. असल में तो वृंदावन बिहारी ही परम उपास्य हैं, शक्ति से पृथक हो नहीं सकते. Only Krishna is to be meditated upon, his bhajan has to be done, and his shakti Radha Rani can never be away from him, because that's why she is to be meditated upon. She can never be away. As you and your energy, both are same and at the same time different. How? Without energy, can I even lift this book? No. Energy and I are same, but still energy is under my control. The way I want, I can lift or I can throw or keep it anywhere. Without energy, I am useless. So they are both one, but an energy under the control of the energetic, that is Krishna. So when we worship both together, that is the highest form of worship. Prabhu ne pucha, aap bhakti aur mukti mein kisko adhik pasand karte hain? But in bhakti and mukti and the liberation, whom do you consider very high? What is it? Rai ne kaha, Rai was saying, प्रभु मुक्ति के नीरस फल को तो कोई विचार प्रधान दार्शनिक पुरुष ही पसंद करेगा. मुझे तो प्रभु के पाद पद्मों में निरंतर लोट लगाते रहने सबसे अधिक पसंद है. कहते और मटेरियलिस्टिक मैन और हु इज नॉट अटैच्ड टू राधा कृष्ण विल आस्क फॉर लिबरेशन एंड ही विल कम अ सुसाइड. सपोज यू आर आस्क फॉर लिबरेशन, यू गेट लिबरेशन, यू आर इन अ रूम, इन दिस रूम यू डोंट फील कोल्ड, यू डोंट फील हॉट, you don't feel hungry, you don't feel anything. For some time you can feel nice. But the mind wants some rasa, you don't get rasa. And the Lord is incarnated and he is praying some passage. Oh Lord, give you also that rasa. Why do you ask liberation? You should have asked bhakti from me. I would have taken you in my pastime and given you the opportunity to taste the rasa. So what the devotees want, they want to always on the Prabhu's feet, they want to lie down and take the dust on their hand, on their head. मैं अमृत के सागर में जाकर अमृत बनना नहीं चाहता, मैं तो समीप बैठकर ही उसकी मधुर माला शासन करते करने को ही सर्वश्रेष्ठ समझता हूँ. I don't want to birth in the impersonal effulgence, then I lose my identity. People, you know, they impersonal, they want to birth in the effulgence. These fools don't understand, if there is a light, there must be a tube behind it. Without a tube, there cannot be a light. Oh, I see the light, but why don't you see the source of the light? The source of light is Krishna. You cannot understand that. He said, I don't want to merge. I want to sit at the shore of the ocean and taste the water of the ocean. Then I want to enjoy the pastimes by being the servant of the lotus feet. This is what he is trying to say. These are the question answers which were spoken. And this is the highest thing which a person can attain. There is nothing beyond this. This is what I spoke to Pati Maharajan Krishna. Today we will be in Nitya Kirtan and Prabhu will be, because being the last day, I will be leaving tomorrow. I thank all of you all for helping me to speak the pastime of the Lord. I try to speak to the best of my capacity. If any mistake, if I offended any of you, I have no intention to offend, because of my way of speaking, it may not be very good. If somebody is being offended, I ask forgiveness, because I don't want to carry a vest of apparat that is for my bhajan. So I beg all of you, one chakal putra bhajcha, kripa sandhu bhajcha, pati kana paavde bhajcha bhajcha. So this is the kirtan. Please stand up and we will do the kirtan for the present floor.
Shri Krishna. कृष्ण गोविंद हरे मुरारी हे नाथ नारायण वासुदेवा हे कृष्ण गोविंद हरे मुरारी हे नाथ नारायण वासुदेवा
Australian.
Oh,
wait,
I forgot.
Yeah.
हरे कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.
Especially for chanting 64 daily. So, all the 8 days we heard only on the glories of Harina, and that also was Roji was telling me in the morning that, you know, I have not even chanted yet. What about ending? It can never end actually. You are saying it can never end. It's impossible to end the glories of Harina. So, we request to Radha Govind Roji to often come here to Asia and inspire all of us. So we remain indebted to him, especially myself. My spiritual life started with him. I heard Hari Katha from him first. So I don't have words to say. We all have heard him for many. Hare Krishna.
Thank you.